It's amazing, actually, the amount or the effect that currencies has on demand travel. Do you think that was probably the most significant thing that contributed to your results?
Yeah, it's a big driver. I mean, I was in the US actually to see our retailers there and the market, and people took advantage of the cheap pound to come and visit Europe. I mean, it's always a strong market, but you know, tourism is so competitive these days. Everybody wants to attract tourism, and definitely the UK has benefited.
We saw a very sharp rise in your Christmas passenger figures, I think up 29%. Is that FX as well?
No, that's purely the UK market especially, which and it's a big sign of confidence it's a discretionary spend, obviously, to go for a Christmas shopping trip to Paris or to London. And people are confident and they're spending the money, so long may it last.
OK, I think Tom is planning a couple of shopping trips. Are you raising prices at all?
No. We keep our pricing stable. It's very competitive out there with all the low-cost airlines in Europe. So, still competitive, but doing well.
Tell me about Brexit and the idea that Brian Moynihan is going to move Bank of America to Paris. I assume the Paul-Roger champagne was broken out at Eurostar headquarters in London, in Paris. If we call it the Moynihan Express, is Brexit good for you? It's got to be good for you, right?
Well, at the moment, the preparation for Brexit are very good for us. We see a lot of businesses traveling a lot between the two cities to, prepare for Brexit. And if some jobs go from London to Paris, it's all good for us, I have to say.
Well, the surveillance travel team suggests that Eurostar can be fine, particularly when you're sitting up in the fancy part of the train. When are you going to expand this experiment to other cities?
So we are going to go to Rotterdam and Amsterdam next year, which is linking London and the Netherlands. It has been a long-term dream for us, and it's coming very quickly now. So spring next year.
That's a long-term dream over here as well. Don't you agree, Francine? I mean, to gallivant.
Yeah, I just wonder. Sorry, Tom. You want your own train, don't you?
Yes.
Kind of want the surveillance train so that we go around gallivanting, bringing you kind of exclusive mathematics and a very strong equation. I'm not sure the Eurostar CEO would be up for that, but maybe. Nicolas, would that route actually risk cannibalizing your UK-France route?
No, it's really on top of it. And we're expecting a lot of growth from that. The Amsterdam is a booming city at the moment. Actually, a lot of companies from the US are moving their headquarters there. So I think it's good for us.
So Tom is asking, rightly so, about Brexit. And Tom, I guess one of the big concerns we have here is border forces, right? Is people being concerned that they need to wait for hours and hours at passport control and stuff like that. Are you talking to border forces about worst case scenario with Brexit?
Yeah, we're talking constantly to the authorities about everything. And actually, we're investing in advance of that in a facial recognition technology for passport control. So we've deployed it already in London, Paris, Brussels, and we're adding more and more machines to ease the flow. So there is a constant discussion with the authorities on that.